say in the review that the parks we saw were light. That came out back in May 19th, 2017 of this year. When I first heard snippets of the track, of my first heard snippets from the album One Light, I was like, wow. I was just like, so intrigued. When I first heard title track Heavy that they did with singer guitar, the track is so well spoken, so well done. Basically, when the track Heavy came out, it's basically as an old tribute to Chris Cordell, late great Chris Cordell, who passed away that fatal year. Basically, Chris Chester Bennington at the time was best friends. He was friends with the late Chris Cordell. Mike Shinoda's sealed record, I quote, that Chester couldn't bring himself. He couldn't finish the rest of the song because during the last bit of the song, Chester Bennington was still reeling. And the loss of a songwriter from Chris Cornell, who took his own life, and Mike Shinoda said that he couldn't finish the song because it was still the death of Chris Cornell that really had just been to her heart, because they were like best friends at the time. I definitely think the track Heavy really said about the song too, but basically the rest of the album. It was produced by Brad Delson and Mike Shinoda. This album marked a shift from Warner Bros. On the previous album's producer album in pre-production of Warner Bros. Like in 2015 during the temporary tour of Shinoda on this film. Made production of the series to win. It was at the downside of the right songs, including external album.
Death of Chris Cornell that really hit him
so hard, and the track heavy was just, it was just done so beautiful. And the way how the video of the song somehow was played out, it was done so beautiful. I definitely think, to my knowledge, like a part of me, they thought, more EDM sound, as some people would say, but I mean, just had Clavery, along with Justin Parker coming on with John Green, Blackbear, Andrew Goldstein, Andy Wright, Andrew Willis, Andrew Dawson, R.U.C. Carter, Rock and Rose. There were some people's ones, but it sounds very secure. November 16th, Dark of the Dark, singing Sorry, Cure, and the Great Person, and the Great Son, and the Son, and the Great Person, and the Great Son, 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 which had Rick and Rob, Bush and T, and Coach Hip Hop, Marsh, Stormzy. I was just, you got Pusha T as R&G on the track, Goodbye. I mean, that was just beautiful. I mean, Pusha T, hands down, one of the best rappers. You got Stormzy on the track. I knew it from the beginning because, you know, I'd done my research way before this album came out. But when you got Stormzy, up and coming English hip hop artist, I mean, Stormzy, he is, without doubt, the next big thing in hip hop. And you got Pusha T of Clips fame. I was just like, I knew that from that track when it came out, that track was gonna be a banger. And when you got the track Goodbye, which had Pusha T and Stormzy, I definitely think Linkin Park at the time was really going to be really big and really heavy and really kind of like melodic. Pushed the boundaries. The track heavy, just stated, it was very light. It's not heavy. It wasn't like Linkin Park, they took the song heavy and they really made it like they want, like, it's very driven, of course. It's very done, well done. So as we're talking to myself, was released July 20th, the same day that Bamber Justin Bandana's passed away. It was definitely a good way to Justin Bandana to go out on his own terms. I mean, the way that he passed away, and the way after, this was like when they toured and promoted the album, it was just, when they were expecting to tour, but from in South America, and they toured to the Dallas Festival of Harris, Ireland Festival of Never Rock, and Pack Festival. They toured like so many places. The record was canceled following the passage of Sabine back in July this year. I mean, gave it like a 1 out of 5, Rock's on 6 out of 10, News Day a B+, London News Standard, 2 out of 5, Consequence on Key, a D+. Consequences sound, if you're watching this video, why would you give it a D+? Really? Really, Consequences sound, if you're watching, why would you give this album a D+? Are you kidding me? Consequences sound, you got no good taste in music. Really? That's just despicable. Consequence of Sound gave this album a B+. Are you me? Really? Really? You gave this album a D+. Are you me? Consequence of Sound, you guys should be ashamed of yourselves to give me Linkin Park, one of the highly successful bands
of all time. You gain one more life, a D+. Really, you guys should be ashamed of yourselves. And in fact, consequence of you guys should turn all your everything music related and just be gone. Because consequence of you guys got no good taste in music. The way you reviewed an album like that, very rude, very disrespectful to a band like Linkin Park. Come on. Consequence of you got no good taste in music. Sorry, I just had to get that out of my system. It just ruined the alchemy. A group called Consequence of Sound, he gave this album a D+. Really? How rude. How disrespectful. Sorry, I just had to get that out of my system. It just